Hello, everyone, and thanks for joining me today as we get a little bit of a sneak peek into my keynote this year at the RSA conference. What we're going through is the industrial cyber threat landscape. Now, specifically, we're looking at 2019 in review. And the reason for this, and really the whole point of the talk, is it's really hard to get insights into industrial security and insights into what's going on inside of industrial networks of these companies around the world. Historically, we've not really had a lot of those insights shared publicly, and it's hard to really push the needle in security forward if we're not really categorizing and understanding things that have happened. So we started this at Dragos. Every year we publish our insights off of threats, vulnerabilities, and incident response cases and lessons learned. It's really a hat tip to the Verizon DBAR as well as the various CERT reports around the world that have been published on different, more enterprise topics. And this is our contribution back to the community to hopefully be valuable. Now, there's a couple things that you're going to hear about in my talk, and so I'll kind of, again, preview here. First and foremost, I'm going to give a background of what industrial world really means and what is it to mean that we have an industrial sort of planet with all the different environments that we have. A lot of folks look at it as utilities, maybe oil and gas. You can kind of say manufacturing writ large, but really it's every company. It's building automation systems for the data centers that power the cloud. It's mining for all the different resources we're harvesting throughout the world. It's shipping. It's renewable energy. It's all sorts of different types of manufacturing. It's rail. It's automation across the world. So we really have this really expansive world of view in terms of industrial threats, and largely they haven't been really addressed. Now, companies have done a lot of work over the year to make safe and reliable environments, and that's been awesome. But we really haven't had industrial-specific focuses over the years. Largely, companies have tried to copy and paste their enterprise security strategy into industrial environments. And when you have different mission, different threats, different systems, different risks, that's really not going to be effective. So I'll help attendees understand why our world is different when we talk about industrial and some of the things that are useful towards you. A lot of the theme of this presentation is trying to leave you with guidance and recommendations of exactly what you need to do in the next year. Like I said, we're going to dive deep into the key findings of our three reports here. Every year, like I said, we put this out there. It's for free out to the community. But I just want to highlight a couple of the key points in the presentation, and then even in this preview, highlight a couple things that you're going to see. So some of the things we get into in the vulnerabilities is we have a lot of focus on vulnerabilities in the industrial community. And when you hear about some hyped up event where someone thinks that you can take down, quote unquote, that power grid, although there's not one power grid, they usually talk about vulnerabilities. But vulnerabilities and exploits and malware, while they are important, are less important in industrial than they tend to be in enterprise. In reality, a lot of the types of attacks we're worried about are those that use native functionality in an environment. In other words, if I can turn on and off a circuit breaker to de-energize a substation, I don't need an exploit or vulnerability to do that. That's functionality that's built into the system. So I'm more worried about the adversary behaviors than I am just about their vulnerabilities and exploits. But vulnerabilities still matter. However, we need to be aware of which ones matter. And the state of industrial vulnerabilities is definitely not as good as the state of typical vulnerabilities. As an example, when we look back at all the different industrial vulnerabilities that came out in 2019, we found that 26% of all the vulnerabilities had errors in them, whether it's the wrong CVSS scores, whether it's the wrong process, wrong hardware, wrong software. Sometimes the vulnerabilities that are getting submitted don't even work at all. It's poor validation in QA before it goes out to the public. So you can find yourself in a position to be patching things that don't introduce any risk whatsoever into your environment. These are the kind of insights that we want to bring to folks to also give specifics about where they should be spending their resources. It's hard to do anything in any environment. It's hard to be a blue teamer. But when you're looking at industrial environments, it's definitely important to get it right. Some of the insights we'll highlight, and it'll end up dealing with the threats themselves and not necessarily their vulnerabilities. We, as a community, have always had some level of industrial threats that we've talked about, dating back in the late 90s and moving forward. But we used to only talk about like one threat or one big malware family, maybe a year. Sometimes it was one every 3 to 4 years. But a lot of the reason for that is we simply weren't looking into these environments for threats. And there's a sort of Schrodinger's ICS appeal to it all, where we thought everything was fine because we weren't getting visibility into the industrial environments and the networks. as we started doing that, it became more and more clear that there were more and more threats. Last year in our year in review, we highlighted that there were 9 active threats. This year, we ended up adding 2 new ones, and it brings the total to 11 different teams, 11 different threats that are consistently and specifically targeting industrial control system environments. A lot of the insights we try to bring is what exactly are these threats doing, as well as trying to highlight for folks how to get ahead of them. This year, a big focus of that was MITRE ATT&CK for ICS. The MITRE ATT&CK is a framework that's largely used in enterprise to talk about behaviors of adversaries to get folks away from just thinking about indicators and vulnerabilities and exploits and really getting away from just the technical indicator aspect of the problem and focusing on the tactics and the techniques and the procedures, the TTPs of our adversaries. And MITRE ATT&CK specifically provides a lexicon and knowledge base of those tactics and techniques that people should be focusing on as they think about how they have coverage across their environment against threats, as well as what gaps they might have. So this year, we helped MITRE actually publish their attack for ICS. So Dragos was one of the big contributors. There was a lot of contributors around the world, but being one of the few firms that focuses on the actual threat side of ICS and has an intel team to look at that, and we contribute a lot of our knowledge set. And we were able to help them come up with 86 different tactics that defenders need to be aware of based on the threats that we're talking about. So in the presentation, I'll go through how to use the framework, some of the insights from it, and I'll do some high-level mapping of some of the tactics you should be aware of from the threats that we're tracking currently that would make for really good recommendations for the next year or maybe even 2 years as you go in and invest in your security for the industrial side of the house. And then lastly, as I try to pull down the presentation and start wrapping it up towards the end, I'm going to go through a lot of lessons learned from our services teams, the folks that are out doing incident response and similar. Even as a technology company, we have folks out in the field constantly trying to help our customers and help the community. And so we want to capture those insights and lessons learned for everybody. And we'll talk about key metrics, key areas that we see of issues when we go in and do assessments, things that really got people in trouble when we went to do incident response and folks weren't ready. But we'll also talk about the most dangerous tactics and the most dangerous techniques to be aware of. And we talk about safety system compromise, where we see adversaries modifying a safety system that could actually hurt or kill people. Or we look at the fact that adversaries are getting really aggressive on trying to understand engineering documents and diagrams related to infrastructure, largely from regulatory mandated information. So companies having to put information up on their websites that are actively and demonstrably being used by adversaries to go and target them. So we'll talk a lot about that as well. And then, like I said, as I try to wrap up the presentation, I'm going to end up having 3 or 4 slides specifically on very prescriptive guidance to the community. I find that your mileage will always vary, right? Your program is going to be dictated by your requirements, and your insights into the security challenge will be dictated by your requirements. But a lot of times, all we get subjected to is high-level guidance. So it can be hard to have a frame of reference of use cases or examples of what right can look like. So I'll make sure to be prescriptive in my guidance there at the end of the presentation of literally, a couple controls and a couple ways to get started, and then given the sense that it's a keynote and it's really meant for a wider audience. This material is going to hopefully be a really good insight for anybody interested in the industrial topic, and I'll end up leaving the last slide for resources of getting started in the community, videos, training materials, free white papers, and similar, because really the whole point of this presentation for me is being able to highlight the beauty of our industrial world, how to get involved in doing security, and ultimately what some best practices are in face of the lessons learned we have from the threats and the cases that we work. So I hope you join me at our wonderful RSA here coming up soon. I hope you join me for the keynote and get excited about our industrial world and our lessons learned in it. Thank you.